Hey everyone, another try on haul, and I also have a new Chanel bag that I'm going to show you towards the end of this. Let's start with the first thing, and as always, you guys can let me know what you think. And I normally, like, sometimes when I watch things back on camera, I think they look amazing, and then I watch them back and I'm like, no, they do not look good. And other times I'll get the opposite. I think something's average, then I watch it back and I love it. Well, the first thing, and I think this is so Chanel vibes, is this cardigan. And I've got to tell you though, if you're thinking of getting this, I'll link to it below, but if you're thinking of getting this, when I last looked, there was like two sizes left, so you might want to be quick about it. But some of the things that I love about it that I think make it really Chanel, check out the details on there. Can you see these charms? These charms are really heavy. They're really chunky, heavy. And they're, what is that? I think that's just like the brand label. Then there's a padlock. That is the brand label as well. What is that? A camera, some binoculars. What else have we got? Camera. So it's the same thing all the way down. And if you look close up as well, this is sort of woven. Can I zoom you in? Yeah, that is woven down there. Then you've got the chains either side. And as I say, these are really chunky and heavy, these charms on here. So I'm just wearing it like this, but you know, obviously if you wanted to have a mirror just there, you could wear it sort of more unzipped. Or if you want to put a top underneath, you could just wear it open over the top. Almost like a jacket. The material on it, it's like a knitted type material. And it's nice and warm, but it's not boiling, so I got it for this time of the year. But let me know what you think. What do you think? I think it's quite nice, and I'm just wearing it here with some grey jeans. And I was just gonna wear it with like some white trainers or something, like sneakers. Yeah, so that's the first thing. This is the exact same jumper, but in cream. And it's exactly the same, so it's got the same charms on it, the binoculars, the padlock, the camera, and it's also got the woven detail here. If I zoom you in, with the chains either side. I don't know, I just saw both of these and I immediately thought, they look so Chanel style. And they weren't expensive either. In the grand scheme of things and how much all of like these clothes are these days, they weren't too bad. And I bought them with my own 15% off coupon code, so it got the price really right down. And I also got with it, I saw a skirt from the same brand, and I'll try this on and show you as well. As I say, I'm gonna watch everything back and see what I think, but so far, I really like the black version of this. I actually quite like both of them, but I will know when I watch it back, and you guys can also let me know. So I was sent, some of you might be sick of me saying it, but until that code ends, I'm not gonna not say it, because for a lot of you that watch that haven't seen previous videos, I've actually got a lot of you emailing me now and tagging me on Instagram, which you were doing already, tagging me on Instagram with screenshots of the things that you have bought with that 15% off. And until it expires, and it's only live now for a couple of weeks, actually, I think for two more weeks, it expires on the 11th of April. It's 15% off, and it works on so much stuff, and it now works. I'm really pleased. It works on existing accounts on Farfetch, so there's none of this having to create a new account. I would actually say if you already have an account, just go and shove a load of stuff in your shopping cart that you're interested in, try that code and see what it works on. That's what I did, because I didn't know what it was gonna work on and what it wasn't, because there are some excluded brands, but those excluded brands are brands you would expect, like Gucci and Fendi, and they're the, like, they're, and Tiffany & Co., they're the main brands that you wouldn't expect there to be a discount on anyway. So if there's anything that you want, give it a try. I also bought something from Dior, and I wanted a couple of items from there, but one item was sold out and they're gonna try and get it for me. But one thing I did see is, or that I knew I wanted, is this belt, wrapped up really nicely, as always. It's the CD belt in the oblique. I love the oblique pattern. I'm so glad that they brought this back. It's one thing, even if I, with the saddlebag, I've got a love-hate relationship with it because I feel like it's, I bought one and I actually really like it, but I do feel like it's a weird design and that it could date. But I bought it knowing that, and thank God, I bought it long before the price rises. And so I'm quite pleased with the price I got it for, etc. But I really like the print in general, and I love that they've brought it back. It's one thing I do really like. And yes, stay tuned, because the other item that I'm trying to get is also in the oblique, and I can't wait because I've got an idea for how I'm gonna wear these. I'm gonna wear like a long-ish shirt, probably one of David's, like a white shirt, over probably like leather trousers, and then I'm gonna wear this around the waist over the top of the shirt with this other, with the other item. Finally, let's talk about Chanel. It's a pre-loved piece, and I am, with the exception of, you know, the heart bag, that, although it wasn't pre-loved, I just knew I loved that, and I'm really fortunate that I got that, and I've been using that loads recently. But this was actually, sorry, I'm putting the bag down. This was actually a surprise from my husband, who, I did a live stream with Luxury Promise a couple of weeks ago, and I was so nervous, but then once I got doing it, it was fine. And in that live stream, we basically just showed some bags that we both like, and this one bag came up, and I really liked it from the moment I saw it. And I was doing the live stream, and my husband David, because you can shop on the live stream, and my husband David bought it for me. And it was the sweetest thing, and at first I thought he was joking, but he was like, no, take it offline, I want to get that for you. And it was the kindest thing. It's vintage, it comes in its original vintage dust bag, and these dust bags double as a cleaning cloth. Let's unbox it. I haven't actually seen it since he bought it for me. And this is it. You don't see many of these. This is a square, I think it's a single flap from memory, it's a single flap, square, kind of somewhere in between a jumbo and a medium. And this is a shape of bag that you don't see these days. And it's a shape of bag that whenever I've gone into Luxury Promise, every so often they have one of these in, and I always look at it. I always look at it and I'm tempted by it. And I am really, really grateful to have got it. And one of the things that I love is that none of the gold is tarnished at all. You know how sometimes it can rub off and you can see the silver tone underneath? That has not happened at all. Even on the chain handle, the chain is so different to the new style Chanel's. Like, the chain is really, really chunky and super heavy compared to the new Chanel bags. All of those items, the items I just shown you, they all fit in, but can you see this big gap this side, and also the gap along the top of the bag? And what I like about it is in many ways quite a, it's like a medium size of bag. It's not that big, but it's big enough where it fits actually quite a lot of stuff, as you just saw there. So it's got in it two full-sized wallets, a card holder, this which is a cosmetics pouch, and it's got my lipstick and my powder in it, my phone, and then, as I say, this big space here, and a zip section, which has got the Luxury Promise authenticity card in it, and like another section there. So it's a really good size. One of the things I also like is that I'm quite tall. So if I back up and show you, and I'll wear it crossbody. I'm quite tall, and although I love tiny bags, sometimes they make me look bigger, even taller, because they're so small. But I feel like with this size of bag, it's a better proportion for me. Do you know what I mean? Some of you have said this to me before, or some of you who are petite have said, I want to go for the jumbo, but I feel that it's too big for me. Or taller people have said, I want to go for mini bags, but they're too small for me. It's funny how bags can actually do that. I mean, not that I care, I still wear the mini bags. But this, I love. I'll show you the corners of the bag. None of them have got marks at all. There are no scratches on the base. Look at that. Oh, I love it. and it's a decent width as well. It's just a bag that you can fit so much stuff in. A lot of you have actually spoken to me recently on email, because I've, you know, I'm doing mail times now, but I'm moving to email because the whole written thing is really, really sweet and I love doing it, but actually so many of your cards have been going missing and I don't want you to think that I'm rude by not writing back, when actually the fact is I've never got your card in the first place. So we're moving to written. And in doing so, I've got loads of you writing to me actually about vintage and pre-loved. So there's a difference between the two. Pre-loved is something that's newer, could be something that the person bought yesterday and they've decided to sell it. That makes it pre-loved. Or then you have things that are vintage, which are things that are older. So that particular bag is 1989 to 1991 from memory. And I love that. I love the age of the bag. I love that I'm reusing something. I love that I'm using something that someone else has loved and quite clearly very much looked after all those years ago. And I love that. Please let me know what you think of the clothes. Do I keep them? Do I send them back? I'm feeling like the cardigans, I quite like them, but I would actually really like to get your feedback, because when I did the last haul and I tried on that Balmain jumper, the beige, like the brownie coloured one, I thought it looked good, and I had loads of you kind of being like, the shoulder pads on that are way too much. And when I watched it back, I was like, that it actually looked ridiculous. I liked the fit on the body, but the shoulders were like this. And I did think I liked the jumper enough to be like, do I take the shoulder pads out? But then I was thinking, you know, for the price of that jumper, I do not want to break it and do that. And then the shoulders are baggy where the puff bit should be. So I love getting your feedback. Please do let me know. I'm gonna link to everything below. I will say, as I mentioned, these two cardigans, there was like two sizes left when I ordered them. So if you like them, I would go and check it out, basically go and have a look, and I'll put that coupon code below. Those coupon codes, when they give them to me, they are not commission paying. I don't earn from any of you using them. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.